students, welcome to the lecture. My name is Miss Ifra and this is our second lecture. In our first lecture, we studied about noun and its various types. I told you about the proper noun and common noun, and today I'll tell you further two types of noun, which are collective noun and the concrete noun. Children, collective noun are names for a collection or a number of people or things. Words like group, herd, and array are collective noun examples. Children, you might not know it, but you encounter collective nouns in everyday speech. Collective nouns are words for single things that are made up of more than one person, animal, place, thing, or idea. You can't have a team without individual members. Even so, we discuss a team as a single entity. Now, children, I'll give you few examples. Kindly understand them. Our class took a field trip to the Natural History Museum. It means that the class here is a collective noun. Another sentence. This year's basketball team includes three players who are over 6 feet tall. So the team here is a collective noun. Now, children, I'll explain you the concrete noun. Children, objects and substances that can be experienced through our senses are referred to as a concrete noun. That means we can touch, feel, smell, taste, or hear them. Examples of a concrete noun include flowers, panther, cinnamon, sunset, rain, cookies, etc., etc. The vast majority of nouns are a concrete noun. Take all animals and people for example. You can touch, feel, see, and hear them. You can do the same for objects. Now take example sentences. The yellow flowers flowed from a glass red vase. So in this sentence, the flowers is the concrete noun. Take another example. The sunset unfurled ribbons of red, purple, and gold across the sky. So in this sentence, the sunset is the concrete noun. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.